All right, I know we have more than 20 people here, and I know we have more than that as far as Harry Potter fans are concerned. Let's try that one more time. For this segment, we've got a lot of fun in store for you guys. We're gonna get creative on this. We're gonna look behind the scenes. We're gonna talk about the exhibit that's going on. We've got some special guests that are here with us as well. So, you guys ready to get started? Around the World with Harry Potter, the exhibition. This is going to be a lot of fun this afternoon. Here with us today, we have a film creator and star, as well as the exhibit creator and the operations director. Please join me in welcoming first, Matthew Lewis. That's right, there's Eddie, and Frank is joining him as well, gentlemen. Please join us. So I know it's a little hard for them to hear out there because we got so many screaming Harry Potter fans here today. So we've got all these fantastic gentlemen on stage. We're going to get right into it. But first, let's go down the line. We'll start with you, Matt. Why don't you give an introduction, just in case. You know, we've got some random person out there. Do you know where they were? Here they are now.
Okay. My name's Matthew Lewis. And, I was just in the films for a bit. So they asked me, I don't know why I'm here, really. They asked me to chat about the studio.
Hi everybody, I'm Alan Gilmer. I was the creative director on the exhibition, the theme parks, and everything the films as well, so I've kind of been everywhere with Harry Potter, and this is very exciting to be here today.
My name is Eddie Newquist, I'm one of the creators of the exhibition.
Hi, I'm Frank Torres. I'm the director of operations for the exhibition as it tours the world.
Frank, why don't you get a little bit more in depth and tell us what is your involvement with this project?
I pretty much manage the installation, dismantle, and shipping of the exhibition as we move it from country to country or city to city throughout the world.
All right, very cool. So we're going to advance down here just a little bit more. And thanks. And now, Eddie, why don't you tell us a little bit more about this exhibition?
Well, the exhibition allows fans really from all over the world to get, you know, up close and personal with hundreds and hundreds of props that Matt, you know, used on the films and that Alan and the team and the film of the filmmakers created. And it really allows you to kind of spend the day at Hogwarts while getting up close with all of these amazing props and costumes and creatures.
Very cool, very cool. And I believe we've got a little video we're gonna play.
Yeah, we do.
Let's check it out, watch your video, sir.
Chosen by fate, you are the boy who lived a story that became a phenomenon.
We can expect great things from you.
Now, everything you love from the Harry Potter films, right in your city.
Welcome to Hogwarts Castle!
Harry Potter the Exhibition is really a Harry Potter fan's dream come true.
Hundreds of props.
All the stuff that you see here is all taken from the studio for a film.
Costumes.
I'm a great artistic.
And creatures.
I like the Bandits from the Cola, but it's quite fun.
A once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
I think for the whole time, that's a great exhibit.
To experience the magic of the epic film series.
Things that you've seen in the films are suddenly right there in front of you.
The event you've been waiting for.
You really have the
Wicked. Is finally here. Harry Potter, the exhibition.
Tell us a little bit more about what went into creating it.
Well, you know, we were really welcomed by Alan and the team at Lee Scene Studios. We got to crawl around all the sets and take pictures and photographs of everything while the films were being made. And then I was able to bring my family out, who was here today, which was really special. But we measured everything. We took really great care of everything because, you know, the film team had worked with all of these props and dressings for 10 years or so. So it was really amazing to be welcomed at number one, which we greatly appreciated. But number two, then to be able to go through and pull it all together for the fans.
Awesome. And you, of course, you've been producing exhibitions for a number of great brands and franchises. Why is Harry Potter, the exhibition, so special, and how exciting has it been to present it to fans, I mean, all over the world?
Well, I think the main thing is everybody has a very close kind of personal relationship with the books and the films, and we found that they feel that way about these artifacts and these props and the work of Mina Lima and just so many great people. And so for them to be able to get up close to it is really special. And it really doesn't matter where you are in the world. We have fans show up in costume, and they're as excited as you are about being able to experience this.
That's fantastic. Frank, we're going to throw a question over your way. You've got been to 14 venues in 9 different countries. What are some of the challenges from going taking all these iconic artifacts from place to place?
You know, our biggest challenge is always the timing of the exhibition. We only get about 16 days to set it up from start to finish. So, you know, you can see the image here. We start with an exhibition hall full of stuff. And in those 16 days, we work with have a great team working with me to set everything up and get ready for display. So it's that's really the biggest challenge is the timing.
Any other memorable things that have happened while you visited these different places that you can think of?
You know, we don't have all day, but certainly it's been great fun. Unfortunately, it's not all work. Every now and then we get to get out and explore the cities that we're in, and we had a great day when we got to meet this elephant when we were out on the road at a wildlife park, and it was just a fantastic time for the team to bond together.
What house was that elephant in, Frank? I can't remember.
I think he's still signing up for the Bonnerhorn thing that they're doing now, so we're waiting to find out. He's trying to answer the question.
Whereabouts was that?
That was in Sweden.
Sweden. Wow.
And you were just talking about Pottermore. You were recently featured on Pottermore, Frank, were you not?
I was. It was great fun. They came out to Shanghai to look at the exhibition, and I was able to walk them through behind the scenes. And then they featured that on Pottermore.com, so it was great.
Very cool. And Matt, of course, you're not here just by happenstance. You've actually been involved in this pretty heavily yourself, and I think we got some video that we're going to run here for just a second. So let's do that. Let's check out Matt on the road with the exhibition. Around the world with Matt in 5 seconds.
Thanks, guys.
So you travel the world with the films and also the exhibition. What has been the most memorable experience while you're traveling the globe?
Oh, wow. I feel so fortunate that it's hard to sort of narrow it down to just one particular incident or one moment. The fact that I get to travel literally around the globe, as you said, such far-reaching places, and present this exhibition to the fans internationally, all of that is just incredible. It's one of the things that I find about this exhibition is, with Harry Potter, we don't really have a demographic anymore. It is so universal, it just belongs to everyone of ages and gender and races, and the fact this exhibition can go around the world is that's what I find just absolutely fantastic, and everyone gets to experience it. So I can't really narrow down one particular place or one incident. I just love the whole idea. It's brilliant.
Yeah, and I noticed as we're watching some of the clips here that you've actually shown up in some of these places in some pretty unique pieces of clothing. tell us about the shirts and there's some other surprises that you've come out with as well.
Oh wow. Okay. So this is in Sydney, in Australia, and that is the South Sydney Rabbitohs rugby league jersey. That's Russell Crowe's rugby league team. He owns them. And I got a couple of friends who play for South Sydney, and I'm a big rugby league fan myself. And so I think Eddie was telling me, I didn't quite remember, but Eddie was telling me that I basically wore that shirt for the entire week that we were in Australia. I don't think I took it off. I still have it. I still wear it quite regularly. Yeah. So that was in Sydney, Australia.
Awesome. Now, Alan, I want to get you involved here as well. You've been involved quite a bit too. Why don't you tell us a little bit about the aspects that you've got going on?
Sure. It's what an amazing journey really getting here today and seeing all you guys and just seeing the popularity of Harry Potter globally. That we have so many exciting adventures now. We have several theme parks. We have all the films, the books, the exhibition, which is an amazing experience. Really, it's like a museum. Going into seeing the actual props. You can almost get to touch them, not quite, but get right up to them. Obviously, Frank wouldn't be too happy if he did that. But to show the great work by the teams in London who made the films, and to show that amazing level of detail that Harry Potter is all about. So the journey continues. We have both Hogsmeade, Diagon Alley, we have a park in Osanka, we have Hogsmeade. Very soon we have Hogsmeade and Hogwarts in Hollywood, which is very exciting. So you've all got to come and check it out. It's just been a brilliant time. We're all a family now. We try to make Harry Potter a very special journey for all of you, because we all love it, and we know you love it as well. So thanks for coming and enjoying it.
Awesome, thank you. Now, I know you worked pretty close with Eddie in creating the exhibition, and of course, bringing to life these two world-class things with the parks as well. So what would you say has been the differences between the two as far as the experience in the park and the experience in the exhibition is concerned?
The exhibition came quite early, straight after the films, and it really was, we designed it to be absolutely perfectly matching the films and to be the same story, but it was an opportunity to step into the story. It was amazing when you read the books and see the films, that's as close as you get. But with Eddie's exhibition, you actually get to see the actual costumes, set pieces, sort of beautiful props, and really get to see the love that went into this. It really is a very special thing, the exhibition, how it has become such a phenomenon globally. There's only shut up. But the theme parks, again, are a very different thing. Sorry, I'll shut up a second. They are architecture, and I love that you all can come and walk around Diagon and Hogsmeade and Hogwarts and experience Harry's journey and the other amazing, and Matt's journey, of course. So, thank you.
Yes, absolutely. Now, of course, this all started in 2008 when the concept was created. Did you ever think that this would be extended through, many of you may not know this, but it's been extended through 2020?
No, it's
I think that probably makes Frank very tired. So, Kevin, talk a little bit about that, about the extension going through, and what was it about, this unique experience? Because you're thinking 2008, we jump ahead 3 more years to 2011. There's this unveiling, and it actually shuts down Times Square. What happened with that?
Yeah, well, we were unveiling the exhibition in Times Square right around the video release of Deathly Hallows Part 1, and we had an amazing turnout by cast members, Matt and a number of the cast members, just terrific response. And, the police had to come out and keep crowds back. I mean, it was really quite a phenomenon with the red carpet, and I think we have a clip of this as well.
I believe we do. Check out the video streams.
Special effect, and we'd walk Matt through it, and he was like, yeah, that sounds like a great idea, but there was only a little bit of smoke, so when we went out in front of the when we went out in front of the press, I kept saying to the stage technicians, more smoke, like more cowbell. And unfortunately, Matt walked out and you almost couldn't see him.
We got more smoke.
Yeah, we got more smoke, so that was my fault. I apologize for that.
Yeah, it was like this big reveal and then there was like just nothing there because no one could see it.
And I understand you also made quite a bit of showing with your British pride for the young Seattle fans when you were in
those boxers. Those are boxers.
Above the waistline, below the sweat.
What am I wearing?
What were you wearing?
Okay, right. So that was unintentional. they're not supposed to be on display.
And they're not in the exhibition.
I don't even own them anymore, so if you could track them down, you could put them in there. But they're a pair of Union flag poster shots. It's inexplicable. I don't know what to say about that. I thought I'd just fly the flag across the pond, I guess.
Dude, that smile that you have on there, I don't think it's because of where you are. I think it's because, yes, I am wearing these, and yes, you are seeing them. And apparently you're a lefty as well.
Yeah, that was probably the first pitch at the Seattle Mariners game, which was possibly the most terrifying experience of my entire life. Never played baseball, ever. Never held a baseball, ever.
We could go back one slide and really check out that form, you know.
All right, let's...
I don't know, what do you guys think? Good baseball player?
I made the play. That's the only thing that I cared about, was getting going the distance.
Yeah, apparently that's a big thing, as long as you just get it across the plate.
Yeah, they said that Barack Obama did it, I think in Chicago, a couple weeks before, and he hit the dirt. And so that's making a play was good enough for me.
You win your confidence. So, I mean, obviously you've been around with this exhibition, it's been a great time. What would you say is, like, if someone were to go and see it for the first time, what is a must-see?
Oh, wow. You know, it's the total immersion of the exhibition. I mean, it's fascinating that you explain there how quickly it's knocked up, like 16 days. It's just baffling to me. Because you go in there and it feels like it's not just a museum where you go and you see some bits in glass cabinets. You are actually in this world of Harry Potter, and you never lose that illusion. And I think that's a testament to obviously the work that you guys put in over that time and the design and whatnot. And so just the whole section is incredibly impressive. But I remember just off the top of my head seeing all of just the old props that I used to use, so like the old the mandrakes, all that section, getting to throw the quaffles through the hoops and have a bit of fun with the Quidditch, and the whole thing just it puts you back in that world and you get to experience a lot of it hands on, which is really cool.
And I heard there's a couple of cool Neville items that are in there as well.
Right, yeah, okay, well, we've added stuff over the years to the Neville stuff. I've got over his wand, mm-hmm. and then a few of his costumes, and the Sword of Gryffindor.
Yes, we do, yeah.
Yeah, so that's going in there. And as you mentioned, the mandrakes and a whole bunch of herbology stuff. Neville's cactus, which is the Mimbulus Multum.
Got it right, that's great. Very nice.
Well done.
Dude, they thought I played it for 10 years, oh yeah.
Now, of course, you visited the exhibition and been part of it as well, but now, ladies and gentlemen, we've got two of the exhibition's greatest fans that have a message for all of you, so watch the video screen.
Hello, everyone. So I'd say thank you so much for all the support over the years. You made it great, and long may it continue. And check out all the footage at harrypotterexhibition.com.
Yeah. You know, James and Oliver have joined us in about 10 cities.
10?
10. Well, don't worry. We'll catch up to more. They were in Chicago for our original announcement, in Toronto, Sydney, Singapore, Sweden, Cologne, Paris, Shanghai. So, and they, I think they went to New York twice, but they've been great supporters, and I know they wish they could have been here as well.
So 10 cities, Matt, that was a little surprising to you. Think you'd be able to get out there a little more?
It's a lot of cities. I'm a little bit shocked, that's all. Absolutely. I'm a huge fan of the work that all these guys do, and as I already mentioned earlier, being able to
to take the world of Harry Potter around the world. It really means a lot, whether that's in Australia, here in the US, or in our new destination of buses in Belgium. It's terribly exciting, and if the opportunity comes up and the invite's forthcoming, then maybe you know.
And speaking of those potential future stops, that you made a pretty big announcement yesterday.
Yes, so as we just touched on there, the new exhibition is going to be in Brussels, in Belgium, in Europe.
And we'll be attending said
exhibition. Again, it all comes down to whether these guys want to have me.
I'll have my people call your people. We'll work something out. So, James and Oliver have one final surprise for all of you before we wrap up, so turn your attention to that video board one more time.
Hello, you lovely people there in Florida. I hope you're having a good time in the Wizarding World of Harry Potter. So Oliver and I are going to sign this bottle, and the lucky winner will have it.
So enjoy Harry Potter celebration.
I believe they just had a coffle that they signed, did they not?
They did, just for this occasion.
For this particular occasion, where we are. Right. So this is it. Has anyone ever touched a coffle before? Just not. And their signatures are right there.
You know, there's only... There's only two, but Frank, who's you know, one of our most talented folks on the team, you might have a device that would help add a couple of signatures.
I think so. Matt, would you mind putting your signature on that as well? Yeah. All right, very cool. I'll hand this back to you. And let's have Alan sign it as well, right?
Of course. Absolutely.
Hold on to that there. Yep. Let's find the space. All right, very nice. Well, I mean, as you know, I mean, if you...
Thanks, guys. I'll take that back with me now.
Oh, you can get pens.
You get the
yes, of course.
I mean, these are cool, but I mean, when we sign something, obviously, it's because you want to give it away.
Absolutely.
So, here's a question. Anybody want to win this quaffle? Who thinks that they're pretty skilled and their Harry Potter trivia makes some noise? All right, so I need one enthusiastic Harry Potter. Sweater with the blue shirt. I need you to come out here, please. Come down. You know, come right up here to the fence here. I'm going to ask you a question. If you get this question correct, you're going to win this quaffle. Now, the first question I'm going to ask you is not the question for the quaffle. It's a simple one. The first is, what is your name?
Anna Thea.
Everybody say, hey, Anna.
Hey, Anna.
Anna, where are you from?
Dallas.
From Dallas. Anyone else in Dallas? Anyone else? So, Nicole, you've got to ride it on. All right, cool. So, Anna, here's your question to win this quaffle. Now, you know this quaffle belongs in the game of Quidditch. What other ball is used in the game of Quidditch? Don't yell out the answer. This is all on Anna and her state of Texas. Do you know the answer? What is the answer?
There's a snitch and a bludger.
There's a snitch and a bludger. That's right. Congratulations, Anna, this is for you. Now, before I give this to you, I want you to don't go far, because we're gonna bring you over so you can meet and greet these folks and get your picture with them. Okay? So first is, have you ever held a quaffle before? Here's how you do it. Hold out your hands and don't let gravity take over. All right, let's hear for Anna, ladies and gentlemen. Don't go anywhere. How about a round of applause for our panel, ladies and gentlemen? Hey, Frank, thank you so much for coming.
coming out and joining us, and thank you all, everybody, as well. And please enjoy the rest of your time here at Harry Potter Celebration 2016. Let's give these gentlemen another big round of applause. Thank you so much. Don't you go anywhere, we're going to pull you over to the side. Thanks so much, ladies and gentlemen. Have a fantastic afternoon.